God-given vision is sure. This is what Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 2 have to say. Then the Lord replied, "Write down the revelation and make it plain on tablets, so that a herald may run with it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it will speak, and it will not lie. Though it tarries, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry." So these are Habakkuk chapter 2, verses 2 and 3. And what they tell us is that when God communicates a vision to us, it's good to write it down, because there is a period of time, a period of waiting before the vision is fulfilled. But we are encouraged in verse 3, and we are told that a vision is for an appointed time. There is a Kairos moment, a time that God has chosen for the fulfillment of the vision. So we've got to keep ourselves energized and keep working towards that vision. And what we are told is that, but in the end, it will speak and it will not lie. Though it tarries, meaning though there could be a delay, yet wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. So the fact is that though it may seem like there is a delay in the fulfillment of the vision, it's not really a delay, because God has planned for the vision to be completed at an appointed time. So it's about the appointed time when God is going to bring things to pass, when things are going to be established the way God communicated with us. It's about waiting till that happens. We are encouraged to stay the course. We are encouraged to keep doing what we need to do today. And we are encouraged not to worry, even though we may have a sense of, why isn't God working faster, or God, can't we accelerate things and move quickly? We may have all these questions going through our minds, but what God wants us to do today is to do our part, and just to do that which He has shown us to do today. And as we're doing these little things and trusting God and holding on to God, there is an appointed time when the vision of God will be fulfilled. And so we want to encourage us that the vision that God has given us, that it will surely come, and that we just have to have faith and wait for the appointed time of its fulfillment. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you that, Lord, from Jesus, O God, from you, that we have received, God, a grace from grace, Father God. Lord, thank you, Father, for your faithfulness in our lives. God, at this time, we pray that each one of us, Lord, will be given a greater grace, Father God, to keep doing what you've called us to do. And God, we thank you. We thank you that even as we do that, God, Lord, we're expressing our faith in you, and your blessing is upon our lives, O God. Father God, I pray that, Lord, you would strengthen the hands that serve you, that, God, you would just strengthen the hearts, O God, that minister to you, Father God, that, Lord, we will not be discouraged, Father God, by the things that may seem to go slowly. But Father, we praise you that at the appointed time, Lord, the vision will come to pass, Father, and that the vision will not lie. Father God, right now I also pray for those who are in various kinds of needs. Lord, I pray that they will experience your power, O God. Lord, that same resurrection power that raised Jesus from the dead, Lord, I pray that it will be evident in people's lives, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for all that you are doing miraculously in people's lives, Father God. And God, for that, Lord, we just give you glory. We give you honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.